Here we are post-game live after an overtime win for the Chicago Bulls, 135-130 versus the Clippers. Dom, what do you think the Bulls got out of this? And like, besides DeMar having 50 points tonight, what else did you see from the Bulls that really got your eye?
Well, this is a really galvanizing win. You know, late in the season, you're looking for some signature wins against some good teams, and the Clippers are one of those teams. And you know, other guys other than DeRozan stepped up. Vucevic had a big game, Zach LaVine, and Patrick Williams off the bench. I thought when he came in with his minutes rate, a big-time impact, especially on the boards in this one.
Big A, what do you think?
I think this is a great win for the Bulls here, pulling it out. They were down early in the first quarter, but at the end of the first quarter, they were down by 10. I mean, I just think this was a great performance by the Bulls tonight. I just think they got to lock down their defense a little bit more. They can't be giving up 130 points a night. That won't suit well for them when they make the playoffs this year.
And Dom, what do you think the Clippers can do to rebound off this loss and maybe get another win to make that playoff?
Well, there are points of emphasis on this one. You know, the free throw disparity, if they were to make a few more of their free throws, they probably win this one and they don't even need the extra period for it. You know, Reggie Jackson really stepped up tonight. Paul George had a tough shooting night. And that's, you expect your stars to play big and big-time games. He just had one of those nights where I think it was 2 of 11 from three. You know, you expect him to make a few more, even more around that 5-6 range. So if they can get George back in that shooting rhythm that he was in when he first came back, they're gonna be just fine. I don't really think that there's much concern off of a really gutsy performance by the Bulls tonight.
Big A, what do you think?
I think the Clippers had this game in the bag, being up by 10 at the end of the first quarter. I mean, DeMar absolutely killed them on offense. I mean, Paul George had a tough shooting night. They need to crack down on those missed free throws. Just Dom said, if they made more free throws, they didn't even need the extra period, and they would have won this game easy.
Also, DeMar DeRozan with 50 points tonight, but you also have to look at Vucevic, who had a double-double with 22 points and 14 rebounds. Also have to look at Zach LaVine with 21 points. How do you think about that, Dom?
I think the better player tonight's game was Vucevic, mainly because he was killing them on the boards. And, you know, that size, the Clippers are not a big team. When they made that trade for Covington and Batum, they really shipped out a lot of their bigger guys and are playing bigger forwards, kind of like the Houston Rockets did when they shipped out Capella. They're trying to play more small ball, just bigger forwards. And Vucevic really exposed them on the inside. He did nail a couple threes, but I think going forward for Los Angeles, if they can't contend with these bigger centers in the Western Conference, whether that be Jokic or something like that, they're going to have a tough time because Vucevic was really killing them down low tonight.
What do you think?
I agree. I think they need more size on this team. We're getting killed by Vucevic, who's getting older, and he's not in his prime now. So that should show that they need size, getting beat down low by a smaller center in Vucevic. I just don't know if their size is going to be able to hold up in the playoffs. I don't think they can make a far run.
We are going to wrap things up here from Chicago. We'll see you tomorrow night in Minnesota versus Timberwolves.